وبمحمد. إن الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم تسليمًا كثيرًا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله. Indeed, the most truthful of speech is the book of Allah. وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. And the best guidance is the guidance of our beloved messenger Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. وشر الأمور محدثاتها. And the worst of affairs are those things we newly invent into this religion of ours. وكل محدثة بدعة. And everything we newly invent into this religion of ours is an innovation. وَكُلَّ بِدْعَةٍ ضَلَالَةٍ. Every innovation is misguidance and it leads astray. وَكُلَّ ضَلَالَةٍ فِي النَّارِ. Every going astray and every misguidance is in the hellfire. ثُمَّ أَمَّا بَعْدٍ. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال قال أناس يا رسول الله هل نرى ربنا يوم القيامة؟ فقال هل تضارون في الشمس ليس دونها سحاب؟ قالوا لا يا رسول الله. قال هل تضارون في القمر ليلة البدر ليس دونها سحاب؟ قالوا لا يا رسول الله. قال فإنكم ترونه يوم القيامة كذلك. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, he narrates that the Messenger of Allah, some people said, O Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, will we see Allah, will we see our Lord on the day of resurrection? So he said, do you have to crowd together and squeeze together and squint to see the sun when it's hidden by no clouds? They said, no, O Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, do you have to squeeze together and get close together and squint to see a full moon on a day where there's no, on a night where there's no clouds? They replied, no, O Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he said, so you will see Allah, your Lord, on the day of resurrection as clearly as you can see the sun on a bright day with no clouds and the moon on a bright night, a full moon on a bright night with no clouds. يَجْمَعُ اللَّهُ الناس فيقول من كان يعبد شيئا فليتبعه فليتبعه فيتبع من كان يعبد الشمس ويتبع من كان يعبد القمر ويتبع من كان يعبد التواغيت وتبقى هذه الأمة فيها منافقوها. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he continued saying, similarly, Allah will gather all of the people and say, whoever used to worship anything should follow that thing. So those who used to worship the sun will follow the sun. And those who used to worship the moon will follow the moon. And those who used to worship false deities, false gods, statues and the likes will follow those false deities. And then only this nation, the nation of the Muslims, they will remain, including with them the hypocrites from them, the munafiqeen from them. Allah will come to them in a shape other than they know and will say, I am your Lord. And they will say, we seek refuge from you. A'udhu billah. From you. This is our place. We will not follow you until our Lord comes to us. And when our Lord comes to us, we will recognize him. Then Allah will come to them in a shape that they know. And will say, I am your Lord. And they will say, no doubt you are our Lord. And they will follow him. وَيَضْرِبُ جِسْرَ جَهَنَّمَ. And then he will lay forth the bridge over the hellfire. This is a bridge that every believer will have to cross in order to make it to Jannah or see if they would be falling into the hellfire. قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ فَأَكُونُ أَوَّلَ مَنْ يُجِيزِ وَدُعَاءَ الرُّسُلِ يَوْمَئِذٍ اللَّهُمَّ سَلِّمْ سَلِّمْ. Allah's Messenger ﷺ, he said, I will be the first to cross the Sirat, the bridge over Jahannam, over the hellfire. And the invocation of all of the prophets on that day will be, Allahumma sallim sallim. Oh Allah, save us, save us. And over that bridge will be hooks, similar to big large thorns like the thorns of a Sa'dan. Didn't you see those thorns of a Sa'dan? The Prophet ﷺ, he asked the companions, they said, yes, O Messenger of Allah. He said, so the hooks over that bridge will be like the hordes of the thorns of As-Sa'dan, except that their greatness and size is only known to Allah. And these hooks, they will snatch the people crossing the bridge according to their deeds. Some people will be ruined because of their evil deeds. Some will be cut into pieces and fall down into the hellfire, but will be saved afterwards. حَتَّى إِذَا فَرَغَ اللَّهُ مِنَ الْقَضَاءِ بَيْنَ عِبَادِهِ فَأَرَادَ أَنْ يُخْرِجْ مِنَ النَّارِ مَنْ أَرَادَ أَنْ يُخْرِجْ مِمَّنْ كَانَ يَشْهَدْ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. So when Allah has finished the judgments amongst His slaves, and He intends to take out of the hellfire whoever He wishes to take out from amongst those who used to say and testify and believe and implement لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ, that there is no God worthy of worship except for Allah alone without partners. مُخْلِصًا, the ones who used to say this with sincerity and believing in it. أَمَرَ الْمَلَائِكَ أَنْ يُخْرِجُوهُمْ فَيَعْرِفُونَهُمْ بِعَلَمَاتِ آثَارِ السُّجُودِ وَحَرَّمَ اللَّهُ عَلَى النَّارِ أَنْ تَأْكُلْ مِنْ إِبْنِ آدَمْ أَثَرَ السُّجُودِ فَيُخْرِجُونَهُمْ قَدْ امْتُحِشُوا فيصب عليهم ماء يقال له ماء الحياة فينبتون نبات الحبة في حميل السيل. The Prophet ﷺ, he continued mentioning, he said, we will order the angels to take them out of Jahannam, and the angels will know the people of Jahannam from the Muslimin who went to Jahannam first, who they can bring out to then admit them into Jannah at a later time. They will know them by athar as-sujood, by the marks of prostration on their foreheads. The sajdas they used to make in this life will leave marks that will not be eaten by the fire. For Allah banned the fire to consume any part of the body that has traces of the prostration of the body. So even those who go to Jahannam from this ummah, the fire will not burn the areas of the forehead and the nose, the palms and the knees, and the toes that used to make sajda. Wallahu a'lam. So the fire will not consume this. So they will, angels will take them out. And by then they would have burnt as coal. And then a water called ma'ul hayat, the water of life, will be poured on them. And they will spring out like a seed springs out on the bank of a rainwater stream. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, in the middle of this hadith, we remind ourselves of the importance of the salvation we find in the prayer in the salah. Do you see why we say do not cut it off? Because even if your sins lead you to the hellfire will not burn the areas of the prostrations of your sajda. Your prayers, ya ibadallah, safeguard them, treasure them. Your sujood, take time in them, and do not rush them. Humble yourself and never stop them, no matter what you are doing, no matter how much sin you are committing. Never cut off the prayer so you do not cut off your Lord. Many hadith allude to this. قال رسول الله بين الرجل وبين الشرك والكفر ترك الصلاة. that between a man and between kufr, being a disbeliever and a mushrik, being a polytheist or a pagan, is the abandonment of the prayer. ثم قال رسول الله العهد الذي بيننا وبينهم الصلاة فمن تركها فقد كفر. That the covenant between us and them is the prayer. Whoever leaves the prayer has committed kufr, has become a disbeliever. And our Prophet ﷺ, he told us with that sajda, you want to be close to your Lord, you want to be close to His help, towards His knowledge, towards His guidance, then you increase your dua in the sajda. كما قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أقرب ما يكون العبد من ربه وهو ساجد فأكثر الدعاء. That the closest a person is to their Lord is when they're in sajda, so make more dua in that sajda, and do not rush it. And we remind one another of the hadith of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, where he said that Iblis will say, أمر ابن آدم بالسجدة فسجد فله الجنة. The child of Adam, the servant of Allah, the slave of Allah who follows Islam, was commanded with a sajda. And he did it, so for him or her will be Jannah. وَأَمِرْتُ بِالسَّجْدَ فَأَبَيْتُ فَلِيَ النَّارِ. And I was commanded to make بِالسُّجُودِ, but I was commanded to make one sajda. This is Iblis saying it, Shaytan, the devil, saying, I was commanded to make one sajda and I didn't, I refused. So for me is the hellfire. Then what about the one who doesn't do 17 sujood a day from the sujood that we're commanded to do in our 5 regular prayers? And top that off on a week, and then a month and a year. So what would this person's abode be? So my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, safeguard this prayer. Because any mark of prostration will not be touched by the fire. May Allah protect us from the fire. وَيَبْقَى رَجُلٌ مُقْبِلٌ بِوَجْهِهِ عَلَى النَّارِ. And there will remain one man. After everyone is taken out of the hellfire that's left, there will remain one more man that will need to be taken out of the hellfire. And he will be facing the hellfire. And he will say to Allah, O Lord, O Allah, the vapors have poisoned me and the smoke has affected me and its flame has burnt me. فَصْرِفْ وَجْهِي عَنِ النَّارِ فَلَا يَزَالُ يَدْعُ اللَّهِ فَيَقُولُ لَعَلَّكَ إِنْ أَعْطَيْتُكَ أَنْ تَسْأَلَنِي غَيْرَهُ فَيَقُولُ لَا وَعِزَّتِكَ لَا أَسْأَلُكَ غَيْرَهُ فَيَصْرِفُ وَجْهَهُ عَنِ النَّارِ. So this last man from the ummah of Muhammad ﷺ, or from those who followed Allah, who had Tawheed in their life, the last one that will be able to be taken out of Jahannam before those who are left in it will be there for eternity. He will say, please turn my face away from the fire. So he will keep on begging Allah and invoking Allah and asking Allah till Allah says to him, perhaps if I take you out of the fire, you're going to ask me for something more. And he says, no. He says, no, by your power, I will not ask you for anything else. So then Allah will grant him his dua and turn his face away from the fire. ثُمَّ يَقُولُ بَعْدَ ذَلِكَ يَا رَبْ قَرِّبْنِي إِلَى بَابِ الْجَنَّةِ فَيَقُولُ أَلَيْسَ قَدْ زَعَمْتَ أَنْ لَا تَسْأَلَنِي غَيْرُهُ وَيْلَكَ إِبْنَ آدَمْ مَا أَغْضَرَكَ فَلَا يَزَالُ يَدْعُو فَيَقُولُ لَعَلِّي إِنْ أَعْطَيْتُكَ ذَلِكَ تَسْأَلَنِي غَيْرُهُ فَيَقُولُ لَا وَعِزَّتِكَ لَا أَسْأَلُكَ غَيْرُهُ فَيُعْطِي اللَّهَ مِنْ عُهُودٍ وَمَوَاثِيقٍ أَنْ لَا يَسْأَلُهُ غَيْرُهُ. Then this man who now he was granted the dua to at least have his face turned away from the fire. And he promised he would not ask Allah for anything else. Until some time passed, and he said, oh my Lord, bring me at least near to the gates of Jannah. Bring me near to the gates of paradise. And Allah will say to him, didn't you promise you wouldn't ask me for nothing else? Didn't you promise you said you wouldn't ask me for anything else or beg me for anything else? Woe to you, O son of Adam, how treacherous you are. The son of Adam betrays. The son of Adam cannot be trusted. And even with his Lord here, this one being taken out of Jahannam is asking after he promised he wouldn't do something. So the man will keep invoking Allah, keep asking Allah until Allah says, okay, but if I give you this, if I bring you near to the gates of paradise, You're going to ask me for something else. And the man will say, no, by your power, I will not ask you for anything else. Just bring me close to the doors of Jannah. He will give Allah his covenant and promise not to break it or ask for anything else after. فَيُقَرِّبُهُ إِلَى بَابِ الْجَنَّةِ فَإِذَا رَأَى مَا فِيهَا سَكَتَ مَا شَاءَ اللَّهُ أَنْ يَسْكُتْ ثُمَّ يَقُولْ رَبِّ ادْخِلْنِي الْجَنَّةِ ثُمَّ يَقُولْ أَوَلَيْسَ قَدْ زَعَمْتَ أَنْ لَا تَسْأَلَنِي غَيْرُهُ وَيْلَكَ يَا ابْنَ آدَمَ مَا أَغْدَرَكَ فَيَقُولْ يَا رَبِّي لَا تَجْعَلْنِي أَشْقَى خَلْقِكَ فَلَا يَزَالُ يَدْعُو حَتَّى يَضْحَكْ فَإِذَا ضَحِكَ مِنْهُ أَذِنَ لَهُ بِالدَّخُولِ فِيهَا. So Allah will bring him near to the gates of paradise, near to the gates of Jannah. And when he sees what is in Jannah, he will remain patient as long as he can, and then he'll start to invoke Allah again. Oh Allah, oh my Lord, please let me enter this Jannah. And Allah will say, didn't you promise that you would not ask me for anything other than bringing you near the doors of Jannah? Woe to you, O son of Adam, how treacherous you are. On that, the man will say, oh Lord, do not make me the most wretched of your creation. Oh Lord, do not make me the most wretched of your creation. And will keep invoking Allah and asking of Allah and begging Allah until Allah smiles because of him. Till Allah will smile. And when Allah will smile because of him, Allah will grant him permission to enter Jannah. فَإِذَا دَخَلَ فِيهَا قِيلَ تَمَنَّ مِنْ كَذَا فَيَتَمَنَّ ثُمَّ يُقَالَ لَهُ تَمَنَّ مِنْ كَذَا فَيَتَمَنَّ حَتَّى تَنْقَطِعَ بِهِ الْأَمَانِ فَيَقُولَ لَهُ هَذَا لَكَ وَمِثْلُهُ مَعَهُ قَالَ أَبُو هُرَيْرَةَ رضي الله عنه وذلك الرجل آخر أهل الجنة دخولا رواه البخاري. This hadith concludes, and it is in Sahih al-Bukhari. So then this last man to be taken out of Jahannam, he will be granted entry into Jannah, into paradise. And he'll be addressed, wish for so and so, or such and such. And he will wish until all of his wishes will be fulfilled. Then Allah will say, all of this, what you have wished for, and as much again therewith are for you. Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, he added that this man will be the last of the people of paradise to enter paradise, to enter Jannah. May Allah make us of those who enter Jannah. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونصلي ونسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا وبعد. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, you just heard a hadith of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم from Sahih al-Bukhari, where Allah, he will speak to the last one that will be allowed to be removed from Jahannam. Because from the blessings of being upon this deen is that even if you go to Jahannam, Allah will take you out. But our goal should be to never see a second in the hellfire. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Ibad Allah, you are servants of Allah. You are servants and slaves of a Lord that smiles, that laughs. Remember, we affirm this, but we don't ask how. Because we do not know how Allah looks. كَمَا قَالْ لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٍ وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْبَصِيرُ. There is nothing like unto Allah, comparable to Allah, and He is the all-hearing, the all-seeing. But when something is affirmed, part of our aqeedah, if we're on what is correct, if we're on what the salaf of this ummah were upon is correct, if we're on what the righteous predecessors, the sahaba, the tabi'een, the tabi'een are upon, then what is correct is that we affirm that Allah laughs and smiles, but we don't know or ask how or why. But you have a Lord that laughs and smiles. You have a Lord who created you to worship Him. كَمَا قَالُوا وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسِ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. As Allah said, I did not create jinn or mankind except to worship me. You have a Lord who knows that you are weak, who knows that you sin, and if you did not sin, He would replace you with a whole other being of people who would sin just so He could forgive them. You have a Lord who wants you to make it to Jannah, who wants you to obey Him and follow His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and leave off your desires for Him, and He'll give you a reward for eternity, not this short, measly life that we throw everything in the basket to live. You have a Lord who has لَهُ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَى وَالْمَثَلُ الْأَعْلَى. You have a Lord who to Him belongs the most beautifulest of names and attributes. To Him belongs the loftiest of descriptions, highlighting His mercy, highlighting His forgiveness. Your deeds will not get you into Jannah. It is the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that will get you there. So do not lose out on this. Allah said, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِ الَّذِينَ أَصْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. Allah says what means, say, O ibadi, O my slaves who have transgressed against themselves by sinning, by doing evil deeds, by transgressing the limits of Allah, do not despair for the mercy of Allah. Despair not of the mercy of Allah. It is always there for you if you want it. Verily Allah forgives all sins. Truly He is all forgiving and most merciful. Even if you've lived a life of sin upon sin, major sin upon major sin, turn to Allah بِالتَّوْبَةَ النَّصُوحَ, with that sincere repentance. Last week we mentioned the corrupt heart. Al-Hasan al-Basri's statement that the corrupt heart, it is the heart that plans a sin while planning repentance, while planning the tawbah. Right? Don't be like this. Turn to Allah بِالتَّوْبَةَ النَّصُوحَ, with that sincere repentance. Straighten your life up. Do the actions of the people of Jannah, regardless of what you did before this second that you're hearing these words. You can turn it around and flip it around. So never, ever, ever start by committing shirk. Never, ever, ever miss a prayer so you do not cut off Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says, وَإِنِّي لَغَفَّارٌ لِمَنْ تَابَ وَآمَنَ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا ثُمَّ اهْتَدَى. Allah says what means, and verily I am indeed forgiving to him who repents and believes in my oneness and does not associate partners with me in worship and does righteous good deeds, and then he remains constant upon doing them till his death. إِنِّي لَغَفَّارٌ. I am a forgiver for the one who is of this way, that repents and believes and does righteous deeds. وَلَوْلَا فَضْلُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ وَرَحْمَتَهُ وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ تَوَّابٌ حَكِيمٌ. And had it not been for the grace of Allah and His mercy on you, He would have hastened the punishment upon you. The sin, the sins we do, the punishment could be levied right away. But it is Allah's grace and Allah's mercy that He withholds that. He withholds that from us. And that Allah is the one who accepts the repentance to all wise. غافر الذنب وقابل التوب شديد العقاب ذي التول لا إله إلا هو إليه المصير. The forgiver of sins, the acceptor of repentance, the severe in punishment, the bestower of favors. لا إله إلا هو. There is no one worthy of worship except for Him alone, without partners, and to Him is the final return. وَأُزْلِفَتِ الْجَنَّةُ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ غَيْرَ بَعِيدٍ. And paradise will be brought forth near to the muttaqoon, near to those who keep their duty to Allah and fear Allah and live their life following Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam the best as possible. The muttaqoon who put a barrier between themselves and Allah's punishment by obedience and staying away from disobedience. Paradise will be brought near to the muttaqoon. It will not be far off. هَذَا مَا تُوعَدُونَ لِكُلِّ أَوَّابٍ حَفِيظٍ. It will be said, this is what you've been promised for those who are oft returning. This has been said, clarified by Allah, that you're not going to be perfect. You're not going to be sin-free. You're not going to do everything you were commanded to do. But the ones who are oft returning, look at how Allah mentions Jannah with the one who makes tawbah. This is what you were promised. That if you stayed on tawheed, and you lived by this tawheed, and you worshipped your Lord, and you safeguarded your prayers, that you would be promised this, and Allah will fulfill bringing Jannah to your foot, to you, to the feet, your feet to that, the gates of Jannah. This is what you are promised for those oft returning to Allah in sincere repentance, and those who preserve their covenant with Him. Allah knows we will sin, so run back to Him in repentance. من خشي الرحمن بالغيب وجاء بقلب منيب. The one who feared the most beneficent, who feared Allah, who feared his punishment. He knew Jahannam was already burning, already raging, causing the severe heat in the summer and the severe cold in the winter. These are the breaths Jahannam takes because of how it was eating itself up. Who feared the most beneficent in the ghayb without seeing them in this worldly life before seeing and meeting Allah, and brought a heart turned in repentance to him, absolutely free from each and every kind of shirk. That call for the people of Jannah on the day where you will get the greatest of gifts to see the face of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, where he will say, أَيْنَ عَبَادِ الَّذِينَ أَطَاعُونِ بِالْغَيْبِ وَلَمْ يَرَوْنِي. Where are my servants who used to worship me, pray to me, fast for me, make hajj for me, give charity for me, and so on and so on, for me, even though they did not see me. Even though they did not see me, where are those servants? Because I'm calling them to a meeting with me so I can show them my face. And this is the greatest of gifts in Jannah. أُدْخُلُوهَا بِسَلَامٍ ذَلِكَ يَوْمَ الْخُلُودِ. So enter Jannah in peace and security. This is the day of eternal life. A day of eternal life in Jannah. No sadness, no depression, no anxiety, no illness, no old age, no heartache, no sickness. Nothing but perfection from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For eternity, not 70 years or 80 years or 90 years or 100 years or 110 years. Forever and ever. Eternal bliss, eternal peace, eternal happiness, eternal health, whatever it may be. أُدْخُلُوهَا بِسَلَامٍ ذَلِكَ يَوْمُ الْخُلُودِ. So enter that Jannah in peace and security. لَهُمْ مَا يَشَاءُونَ فِيهَا وَلَدَيْنَا مَزِيدٍ. There they will have all that they desire. And we have more for them. A glance at the face of Allah. A glance at the face of Allah. Many of us rely on the descriptions of Jannah, not thinking of the greatest gift being the face of Allah. The hadith of Qudsi, where the Prophet ﷺ said that Allah said, أَعْدَدْتُ لِعِبَادِ الصَّالِحِينَ مَا لَا عَيْنٌ رَأَتْ وَلَا أُذِنٌ سَمِعَتْ وَلَا خَطَرَ عَلَى قَلْبِ بَشَرٍ. The hadith where the Prophet ﷺ said that Allah said, I have prepared for my righteous servants what no eye has seen, what no ear has heard, and what cannot even occur to the human heart. Yet we have even better than the homes and the rivers and the drinks and the food and all this of Jannah. Because Allah said, لِلَّذِينَ أَحْسَنُ الْحُسْنَ وَزِيَادَةً. To those who do good and believe, they will have great things, and they will have more than that. And it is the glance at the face of our Creator, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So what are you living for? Who are you living for? Who is the one you want to please? And who is the one you want to love you the most? If you seek the love of the people, go for it. But you will lose and lose royally. But if you seek the love of Allah, He'll grant you it. To the point that even if you go to the hellfire one day, you may be one of the ones pulled out, washed with that water of life, and granted admittance into His Jannah. فَاسْتَعِدُوا عِبَادَ اللَّهِ لِلِقَاءِ رَبِّكُمْ. So be prepared for the day you meet your Lord, my brothers and sisters in Islam. وَأَحْسِنُوا ظَنَّكُمْ بِهِ. And have good thoughts of your Creator. كما قال رسول الله قال الله أنا عند ظن عبدي بي. As our Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said, that Allah said, I am as my slave thinks of me. I am able to do for him what he thinks I can do for him. So think good of your Lord, because he is as his servant thinks of him. And from this is doing good deeds, and turning to him in tawbah and repentance, and thanking him for the blessings and the favors and the provisions. Remembering, وَإِن تَعُدُّ نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا. That if you were to count the blessings, the favors, the gifts that Allah gave you, you would never be able to enumerate them all. You wouldn't even come within a trillion of them, because of how greedy we have become. فَعَبَادَ اللَّهِ اتَّقُوا اللَّهِ. So, O servants of Allah, fear Allah, وَاعْلَمُوا أَنَّكُمْ مُلَاقُوهُ. Know without a doubt, with full certainty in your hearts, in your minds, in your bodies, in your souls, that you will meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah make us of those who are steadfast on this deen, and those who are admitted into Jannah. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, briefly, we're not going to do a formal fundraiser, but we're at the time of the year where the masjid, especially with the time that has passed, certain things need to be done to maintain it. Alhamdulillah, it's well maintained, and we want to keep it this way. The concrete, before the rain comes outside, it needs to be painted with a special sealer and some sand granules put under it so that it's not slippery. Right now, there's a ton of slippery patches when it's wet. This is about $1,600. The asphalt of the parking lot, you're seeing the pebbles and the breakage. The cracks were sealed, but now you need to seal the whole asphalt. This is about $5,700. The flat roof and the dome, these have areas that need to be sealed with time so that they don't begin to leak. And leak, of course, if it was here, it would leak into the main hall. This is about $6,300. Islamic books that we need for some of the school that we've been handing to the parents, to the kids. The Arabic books, the Quran books, and the likes of this, $1,000. And a projector and a screen to present to the kids and teach the kids their Islamic studies that we've installed in the social hall was $1,000. So this amounts to about $15,000. That if we could raise it today, may Allah bless you. This is your sadaqah. This is a sadaqah jariyah. We'll continue to use these things. And it will be an ongoing charity for you. No formal fundraiser. If who wants to give 1,000 or 500 or 100 or 20 or 50 or 10 or whatever else it may be. Anything will help. If you want to sponsor one of these, first come, first serve. It's yours if you tell me and you mention it. So be mindful of this. We need to maintain our masjid. And much of this is support for the continued activities that we're doing and what we want to get back to when things easing up with COVID. بإذن الله تعالى اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك أنت سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبا على دينك يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبا على دينك يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبا على دينك اللهم إنا نسألك الجنة اللهم إنا نسألك الجنة اللهم إنا نسألك الجنة الفردوس الأعلى اللهم أجرنا من النار اللهم أجرنا من النار اللهم أجرنا من النار يا أرحم الراحمين سبحان ربك رب العزة أما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين